Hello everyone, my name is Sonam Sandhu and today I'm going to discuss a very essential thing for your IELTS preparation, and that is related to IELTS writing task 2. Guys, I know there are several students out there who are unable to score 7 band in writing module. Here I'm not going to discuss the strategies for 7 bands. Basically, this session is going to be for half an hour and I'll cover every single thing essential for getting or scoring 7.5 band in writing module. So I'll recommend you to watch this video till the end so that you understand every single thing in detail. Okay, so I'm going to start this session with the assessment criteria. As when we are talking about assessment criteria, we really need to know why the examiners are giving us 6.5. Okay, why are we consecutively getting 6.5? What mistakes are we committing? What do we need to do? So this whole session is going to cover every single thing related to your IELTS writing task 2. Guys, one more thing is here. If you'll understand this thing in detail, I'm sure you'll start getting, basically after following this video, you need to follow this. After following this, you should write minimum 20 essays. And I can assure you, you can get 7.5 in writing module. You can get those essays checked by me as well. And for that, you can contact on the numbers. So in this session, I'm going to cover two things, okay? So what I'm going to cover, firstly, I'll be covering the assessment criteria. And that's for writing task 2, as the assessment criteria is a little different from task 1, okay? So when it comes to writing task 2, what am I discussing? I'm discussing assessment criteria. Next thing is 7 steps or techniques, only 7 techniques, guys. With these 7 techniques, you will definitely start scoring 7.5 in writing module. And I can give you assurity. If you'll follow this properly, you'll not face any problem. The third thing that I'm going to discuss is the range of grammatical sentences here. Because what are you doing? You are unable to use variety of sentences. So I'm going to discuss this as well in today's video. Okay, so I hope this session will be useful for you all. Please watch it till the end. If you really like my teaching methodology, subscribe my channel. Thank you so much, guys. Let's get started. So the first thing here is the assessment criteria. I believe many of you don't even know what exactly is there in assessment criteria. So first thing that you need to know about assessment criteria is task response. Okay, so what is task response, guys? When it comes to task response, there is a very thin line between task response and task assessment. I won't say exactly thin line, because when you'll understand it in depth, you're going to understand, you'll feel that there is a huge difference between these two. When it comes to response, it is for essay writing. Why is it for essay writing? Because essay writing में क्या होता है कि आप respond कर रहे हो, okay? You are responding, you are giving response on a particular question. If you are agreeing to a particular question, why are you agreeing? Why do you support? So let's say here Sonam Sandhu. So according to Sonam Sandhu, the reasons are different. If I'm agreeing that consumption of junk food is leading to obesity, okay? So my reasons are going to be different than Raminder Sandhu's reason, okay? So two different people, two different reasons, okay? They'll have different views about a particular topic. That's the only reason it's response. So it varies from person to person, okay? So that is task response. Next one is coherence and cohesion. Guys, coherence is organizing your ideas logically. So you really need to organize your ideas logically. What you are doing, you're just writing your answer, you're not even understanding the question, and that's the problem. So you need to make it a point that you understand the question properly. For that, we call it like coherently. Your idea should be coherently, okay, should be coherent. Your idea should be coherent, logically organized. That's coherence. And then we have cohesion. Basically, cohesion is using connectors. So you have to use variety of connectors, and that too not the common ones. Okay, so you have to use connectors that are uncommon. Okay, so try to use connectors जो कि हर कोई नहीं use कर रहा. Practically speaking, every other student is not using also. Every other student is not using besides this. Okay, so we have to use different. We have to make our essay look different. For that, we'll be using variety of cohesive devices. But वो cohesive devices should not be more, should not be less. प्रॉपर एक लिमिट होनी चाहिए. ओके, दैट समथिंग यू नीड टू एडिक्वेट नंबर ऑफ कनेक्टेड डिवाइसेस. नेक्स्ट वन इज ग्रामेटिकल रेंज एंड एक्यूरेसी. व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ग्रामेटिकल रेंज एंड एक्यूरेसी गाइस, ग्रामेटिकल एक्यूरेसी इज वट एवर टेंसेज यू आर यूजिंग, वट एवर प्रेपोजिशंस यू आर यूजिंग, यू शुड राइट, यू शुड यूज द टेंसेज एंड प्रेपोजिशंस करेक्टली. ओके, सो ग्रामर, वट एवर ग्रामर यू आर यूजिंग, that should be correct. Whereas range is using variety of sentences, as in conditional sentences, you'll be using passive voice, you'll be using interrogative sentences, you'll be using complex sentences, you'll be using compound sentences. So that's something you need to focus on. So you need to focus not only on accuracy but also on the range of grammar. Okay, and the last one is lexical resource. Guys, lexical resource is not only using, it is not confined to usage of difficult words but to right collocation as well. If you are using the word citizen, you'll not be using good citizen, you are going to use civilized citizen. So you are going to take care of the words, you are going to take care of the words you are using with a particular noun or a verb. So basically the adjective that can be used with a noun or adverb that goes well with a verb. So you really need to take care of this. I hope you understood what exactly is assessment criteria. Now try to understand, when we are talking about essay writing, so essay writing carries 2/3 of the total score of writing module. That means you get out of 6, you get scoring out of 6. And what does it mean? 1.5 for task response, 1.5 for coherence and cohesion, 1.5 for grammatical range and accuracy, and 1.5 for lexical resources. So that's what you need to focus on. Now guys, what are we going to do? Okay, in the next step, I'm going to discuss the techniques. Firstly, I have explained you assessment criteria. Now I'm going to explain you the techniques. Okay, the strategies which I implemented in my essay writing, what all I was doing and what helped me in getting this course. So it's not about me, it's about my students as well, those who have scored. So the first point here is, yes. So basically guys, when we are talking about the first point here is read, translate and underline. You guys are facing problem in task response. And what's the problem, guys? The problem is you're not understanding the question. Okay, so what do you need to do? You need to understand the question thoroughly. Okay, make it a point that you are looking at the question twice, you're skim reading the question, after skim reading you're translating the same in mother tongue. So I'm going to write the question on one of the pages so that you get to know what exactly is the question, and we are going to do everything on the basis of a particular question. Okay, so the question is, consumption of junk food is leading to obesity. Okay, what is your opinion? So clearly guys, they are talking about your opinion here. Okay, So point is consumption of junk food is leading to obesity. Obesity in means fat. ओके सो बहुत सारे लोग हैं जो मोटे हैं, ठीक है. सो दोज पीपल हु आर फैट, उनके लिए हम यूज कर रहे हैं ओबिसिटी टर्म, ठीक है. सो नाउ लुक एट द फर्स्ट वन, दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू ऑल आर लैकिंग इन टास्क रिस्पॉन्स. ओके, एज आई मेंशनड अर्लियर गाइज, देखो लेट्स से दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर, दैट्स ग्रामेटिकल रेंज एंड एक्यूरेसी. वाई? इफ यू आर अनेबल टू फ्रेम अ सिंगल सेंटेंस करेक्ट, ओके, इफ यू आर इवन इफ योर सेंटेंस इज नॉट करेक्ट ग्रामेटिकली, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन योर पॉइंट्स. यू हैव गुड आइडियाज, यू नो हाउ टू ऑर्गेनाइज दोज आइडियाज कोहरेंटली, यू रियली अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चन, बट यू आर अनेबल टू राइट इट करेक्टली. ओके, यू आर अनेबल टू फ्रेम इट करेक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू इन सेंस ऑफ ग्रामर. सो दैट्स द पॉइंट वेयर यू आर लैकिंग. सो आई सजेस्ट यू वन थिंग गाइस, this video is useful for every other student who know basic rules of grammar. If you really don't know, you can go through my grammar playlist as well. Point is, you need to have knowledge about certain points, okay, certain aspects in grammar, tenses, prepositions, okay. So you should know part of speech as well. So you should know all these things, connectors, complex sentences, okay. So when you are sure about all these things, you will not be able to, you will not actually make mistakes in other parts. So focus on grammar at first. So grammar is the base, is the foundation of IELTS. That's the only reason I recommend you all to focus on it. Now proceeding further, I was talking about task response. Task response is understanding a question properly and answering on the basis of a particular question. So when we are reading a particular question, what are we doing? We are reading the question. So we are going to read it, skim read the question. Okay. So I'm going to skim read the question. I'll understand the question. Then I'm going to scan it. I'm going to understand it properly. During the scanning stage, I'll translate my question in mother tongue. Okay, I'll translate the question in mother tongue. That means if I speak Hindi, I'll be translating the same in Hindi in order to understand the question properly. Here, the question is very easy. There is no need of translation, but there are numerous times when you are unable to understand question. So I'll recommend you to understand a particular question properly. Okay, now talking about skim reading, then you're scanning the question, then you're translating the same in mother tongue, and the last step is you are circling. Okay, so you need to do this properly. Okay, that's very important. And how will you be doing this? So firstly, जंक फूड खाना ही क्या है? जंक फूड खाने की वजह से ओबिसिटी हो रही है. ओके, जंक फूड खाने की वजह से ओबिसिटी हो रही है, ठीक है. सो कंजम्पशन जंक लीडिंग ओबिसिटी. So these are the four words. These are my four keywords. Now try to understand what exactly are keywords. Keywords basically hota hai aapka noun, adjective, or verb. Okay, so these three are your keywords. You have to circle only those words. Okay, so basically on the basis of these four words, I can understand my question properly. I need not to read question again and again. I have understood the question only on the basis of these four words. कि junk food खाने की वजह से consumption of junk food की वजह से obesity हो रही है, ठीक है? Consumption of junk food की वजह से लोग मोटे हो रहे हैं, ठीक है? So point is simple सा logic है. What is your opinion? A point they are asking your opinion. Either you can totally agree or you can totally disagree or you can partially agree or partially disagree. So according to me, मैं ये कह सकती हूँ कि यहाँ पे you can explain. अब देखो, point is you have to think about ideas and that is the planning stage, guys. Okay? So first part मेरा clear हो गया है कि मैंने question ध्यान से पढ़ लिया and I have translated the same and I have circled the keyword. Okay? So I really know what exactly is there in this particular question. So that is my first stage, and this is essential for, this is pivotal for task response. If you want to score better in task response, you need to do this. And this particular step mein, what are you going to do? You are going to devote 2 minutes, not more than 2 minutes. 2 minutes are more than enough. Okay, now guys, talking about the second step, and the second step is planning. You have to plan your question properly. You need to plan your ideas. You should know what exactly you're going to write in your answer. So that's the planning stage. And what are you going to do in the planning stage, guys? You're going to devote 5 minutes on this one. You have already understood the question, but planning kaise karni hai? Bahut sare students galat tarike se planning karte hai. They really don't know ki plan kaise karna hai. Agar jo main method abhi bata rahi hu, if you're going to implement the same for 20 essays, for minimum 20 essays, I can assure you, you are not behind 7.5 band. Definitely you are going to score 7.5 band in your writing module. Okay, you'll not be far behind that particular goal of yours. Okay, now basically consumption of junk food is leading to obesity. Ab mujhe question pata and they are asking me your opinion, my opinion. Okay, so that's for sure ki I have to write my opinion. So main kaise planning karungi? I'm going to write body paragraph 1, body paragraph 2. Firstly, I totally support the above assertion. You have to clearly mention your opinion in introduction itself. I totally support the above assertion. Pehle to aapne paraphrasing is karni hai. After paraphrasing, you are going to do this. I totally support the above assertion. Okay. As आप अपना रीजन दे सकते हो, दैट समथिंग आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इन द कमिंग स्लाइड. नाउ बॉडी पैराग्राफ 1, आपने बोल दिया आप टोटली सपोर्ट कर रहे हो, पर क्या लिखना है बॉडी पैराग्राफ 1 में? देयर आर एक्चुअली सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हु डोंट इवन, दे एक्चुअली फॉरगेट व्हाट दे वांट टू राइट. ओके, दे फॉरगेट व्हाट दे वांट टू राइट इन बॉडी पैराग्राफ 1 और 2. सो व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू? व्हाई जंक फूड causing obesity. Okay, ठीक है. सो मैं टोटली सपोर्ट कर रही हूं, दैट मींस मुझे दो रीजन देनी है. आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन माई रीजन नंबर 1 इन बॉडी पैराग्राफ 1 एंड रीजन 2 इन बॉडी पैराग्राफ 2. सो व्हाई जंक फूड कॉजिंग ओबिसिटी, रीजन 1. ठीक है. सो व्हाट इज देयर, आप कोई एक रीजन एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हो कि क्यों जंक फूड ओबिसिटी कॉज कर रहा है? हेक्टिक लाइफस्टाइल ऑफ पेरेंट, दे डू नॉट हैव टाइम टू प्रिपेयर मील्स एट होम. हेक्टिक लाइफस्टाइल ऑफ पेरेंट्स, ओके, बोथ आर वर्किंग. ठीक है. अब आई नो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दिस पॉइंट इन माय बॉडी पैराग्राफ 1 एंड माय सेकंड रीजन इज इजी अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ, इजी अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ फास्ट फूड. ओके, न्यूमरस फूड जॉइंट्स हैव बीन ओपन. Okay, have open, cheap. Okay, so point is these three points are correlated to each other. That's the only reason I'm going to explain it in body paragraph 2. Ab tell me guys, whenever you are planning your answer, I'm sure ki jab bhi plan karte ho, aap bhool jate ho ki question mein kya pucha tha. So what do you need to do? You need to understand the question properly. After understanding the question, you are going to prepare your planning sheet like this. Okay, so you can use the question paper itself and you can plan it on the question paper itself. So firstly, you're going to write your opinion. Ab agar aap totally support karo, that means you have reasons for this. Why junk food causing obesity? Reason 1. Why junk food causing obesity? Reason 2. But let's say mujhe main partially support kar rahi hu, then in my first body paragraph 1, अगर मेरे सामने, इफ आई हैव द क्वेश्चन इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी, तो मैं कभी भी इनकोरेंट नहीं होंगी. सो प्लानिंग इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर राइटिंग योर आंसर्स कोहरेंटली. ओके, सो इफ यू हैव टू, इफ यू वांट योर आइडियाज टू बी कोहरेंट, यू नीड टू प्रिपेयर द प्लानिंग शीट लाइक दिस. ओके, सो व्हाई जंक फूड कॉजिंग ओबिसिटी. ओके, व्हाई इज इट कॉजिंग ओबिसिटी? बट अकॉर्डिंग टू मी, फॉर इंस्टेंस आई थिंक कि जंक फूड इज नॉट द ओनली रीजन. ठीक है, सो जंक फूड कॉजिंग ओबिसिटी एक ये रीजन है एंड दूसरा रीजन है कि कंजम्पशन ऑफ जंक फूड इज लीडिंग टू ओबिसिटी. सो व्हाट इज योर ओपिनियन? आई पार्शियली एग्री. सो मतलब फर्स्ट सेंटेंस मेरा फर्स्ट रीजन हो सकता है कि वाई जंक फूड कॉजिंग ओबेसिटी, ठीक है, वाई जंक फूड इज नॉट द ओनली रीजन, ठीक है, वाई. अब इन बॉडी पैराग्राफ टू जो मेरा क्वेश्चन होगा वो होगा वाई जंक फूड इज नॉट द ओनली रीजन, दैट मीन्स आई हैव अनदर रीजन, इज नॉट द ओनली रीजन, ठीक है, सॉरी, नॉट द ओनली रीजन. ओके, सो व्हाट एम आई गोइंग टू डू हियर, व्हाई जंक फूड, क्यों जंक फूड ही खाली रीजन नहीं है, रीजन पीपल डोंट एक्सरसाइज, ओके, पीपल आर लेथार्जिक, लेथार्जिक, दे डोंट एक्सरसाइज, सेडेंट्री लाइफस्टाइल, सो आई एम क्रिएटिंग माय वोकैब आल्सो हियर, सो आई विल नॉट ओनली बी राइटिंग, ओके, आई विल नॉट ओनली बी प्लानिंग, बट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट द वोकैब अलोंग विद प्लानिंग वन. सो अब मुझे क्लियर है गाइज, मुझे एक चीज बताओ, आई एम श्योर इस मेथड से मेरे काफी स्टूडेंट्स को बेनिफिट हुआ है, मुझे भी हुआ है. सो पॉइंट इज कि ये है, अगर आपने क्वेश्चन लिख लिया, बॉडी पैराग्राफ वन क्वेश्चन ही लिख लिया, आपको पता है कि मुझे किस क्वेश्चन का आंसर करना है, सो आप कभी भी इनकोहरेंट नहीं हो सकते, दैट्स माय गारंटी, ओके. एंड आई हैव सीन 50% ऑफ द आंसर्स आर इनकोहरेंट डिस्पाइट लाइक द फैक्ट सेंटेंसेस वर ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट, ठीक है, डिस्पाइट द फैक्ट ऑफ और सेंटेंसेस वर ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट, देयर आइडियाज वर इनकोहरेंट, क्योंकि उन्होंने प्लानिंग नहीं करी प्रॉपरली. सो दीज टू स्टेप्स आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप्स, ओके. सो मैं सीक्वेंस में ही बता रही हूँ, बिकॉज सबसे पहले क्वेश्चन समझना है, देन यू हैव टू प्लान. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड वॉट आई वॉन्टेड टू कन्वे in these two techniques, okay, so you have understood this well. Now we are going to proceed further with the next one, and that is the third thing, that's like the format, guys, okay, so try to understand what's there in the format. I never recommend my students to write more than four paragraphs, so four paragraph structure is more than enough for every essay type, except to what extent or do the advantages outweigh disadvantages. So every essay type, to what extent or do the advantages outweigh disadvantages. So that's something you need to do. So bas in dono questions ke alawa har ek question mein four paragraph. And for to what extent and that, I'm going to prepare some more videos. I hope you like this video. Aapko achhi lagegi to definitely maine aur videos banani hai har ek question type pe. Itna sure hai ki essay writing is the writing task one and two. Writing basically is the easiest module of all. अगर आपको अच्छा लगेगा, समझ आ जाएगा एक बार अच्छी तरह, आप डिफिकल्ट मेथड से राइटिंग कर रहे हो, सो प्रॉब्लम आनी है, ओके. सो नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज फोर पैराग्राफ स्ट्रक्चर, ओके, एंड व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू दिस, सिंपली स्पीकिंग गाइस, इंट्रोडक्शन, ठीक है, इन इंट्रोडक्शन यू विल बी पैराफ्रेजिंग योर क्वेश्चन एंड यू आर गोइंग टू गिव योर ओपिनियन. इफ द क्वेश्चन इज डिमांडिंग योर ओपिनियन, यू रियली नीड टू राइट योर ओपिनियन इन द इंट्रोडक्शन इटसेल्फ. यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू, you don't want your examiner to wait, and examiner don't want to, they actually, examiners don't want to wait till the last paragraph, okay, or till conclusion in order to see your opinion, that's wrong. So you have to mention your opinion in introduction itself. Now the second one, guys, is, second thing is बॉडी पैराग्राफ वन. एज आई मेंशन्ड अर्लियर, कैसे मेंशन करना है बॉडी पैराग्राफ वन, प्लान कैसे करना है, जंक फूड क्यों ओबेसिटी कॉज कर रहा है, रीजन वन, जंक फूड क्यों ओबेसिटी कॉज कर रहा है, रीजन टू, इफ यू टोटली सपोर्ट द अबव असर्शन. अगर आप पार्शियली सपोर्ट कर रहे हो, सो व्हाई जंक फूड कॉजिंग ओबेसिटी, व्हाई जंक फूड इज नॉट द ओनली रीजन, सो दैट समथिंग यू आर गोइंग टू डू, एंड आई होप दिस मेथड विल हेल्प न्यूमरस स्टूडेंट्स आउट देयर. सो try to follow this for minimum 20 answers, okay, 20 essays. So next is body paragraph 1, then we have body paragraph 2, and the last one is conclusion, okay. So when we are writing to what extent or do the advantages outweigh, then we'll have three body paragraphs, the rest will remain same, okay. Now we are going to talk about the fourth thing. Guys, I have noticed there are numerous students, either they are exceeding the word limit or they are writing, sorry, they are exceeding the word limit or they are writing less. Have you noticed one thing? Whenever you read any question, the question clearly mentions, okay, it clearly says at least 250 words. What does it mean? कि मिनिमम 250 वर्ड्स होने चाहिए, उससे कम बिल्कुल भी नहीं हो सकते. सो दैट मींस आई ऑलवेज रेकमेंड माय स्टूडेंट्स टू राइट 290 टू 300 वर्ड्स. ओके, डू नॉट राइट लेस देन दिस. एंड आई विल रेकमेंड कि बहुत ज्यादा भी मत लिखो. आई वोंट से कि किसी के भी स्कोर नहीं आएगा अगर 350 प्लस होगा, डेट वेरीज, पर हमारे पास इतना टाइम ही नहीं होता गाइस. सो मेक इट अ पॉइंट कि 290 टू 300 लिखो, रेलिवेंट लिखो, डू नॉट रिपीट द इंफॉर्मेशन. दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. सो यू आर गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन वर्ड लिमिट. अब वर्ड लिमिट पे कैसे फोकस करना है जरा ध्यान दो. व्हेन इट कम्स टू इंट्रोडक्शन, सो यू आर गोइंग टू राइट 50 टू 60 वर्ड्स, इजिली हो जाएंगे. पैराफ्रेज भी करना, ओपिनियन भी लिखना. ओके, देन यू आर गोइंग टू फ्रेज योर, आई टोटली सपोर्ट दी, जैसे आपने यहाँ लिखा है, टोटली सपोर्ट दी अबव एजर्शन एज पीपल हैव हेक्टिक लाइफस्टाइल एंड एज पीपल हैव हेक्टिक लाइफस्टाइल एंड द फास्ट फूड इज इजिली अवेलेबल और owing to hectic lifestyle of parents and easy availability of fast food. So I am explaining, I'm giving my opinion, I'm stating, I'm going to outline my ideas in introduction itself. That's something I'm going to do in introduction itself. So definitely 50 to 60 words ho jayenge. Then we have body paragraph 1, 100 to 110 words. Body paragraph 2, again 100 to 110 words. And conclusion, guys, not more than 30 to 40 words. Okay, so conclusion mein you just have to state whatever you have mentioned above. So body paragraph 1 and 2 ka bas apna jo opinion hai usse clearly state karna on the basis of the ideas described in body paragraph 1 and body paragraph 2. So I hope you have understood all 4 points. And the fifth point is focusing on examples. There are numerous students out there, theek hai, who are not even writing examples. They don't even know how to write examples. So it's must, guys, you should mention 2 examples in every essay of yours. 2 examples, one in body paragraph 1 and other in body paragraph 2. ठीक है, अब एग्जाम्पल कैसे लिखना है, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस गाइस. एग्जाम्पल जब भी लिखना है, सो यू आर गोइंग टू मेंशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एन आर्टिकल. सो कैसे लिखोगे, एन आर्टिकल पब्लिश्ड इन द टाइम्स और द ट्रिब्यून. ठीक है, पोस्ट ऑफी सिंगल हाइफन स्टेटेड दैट. अब क्या स्टेट करा, मोर देन 70% ऑफ द पेरेंट्स आर वर्किंग एंड ओइंग टू दिस दे order food from outside. Okay, they order food from outside or they order from for food from various food joints. Guys, example का मतलब है जो आपने idea दिया है उसी idea को support करो. अगर मैंने लिखा है hectic lifestyle है parents का, so मैं वो ही करूँगी. मुझे अपना idea देना है और मुझे बताना है कि 70% of the parents पर कहाँ पे, इन द यूके, मैंने यूके की बात कर दी. इन द यूके आर वर्किंग एंड ओइंग टू दिस दे ऑर्डर फूड ऑनलाइन. दे ऑर्डर फूड ऑनलाइन. ओके, सो बाहर से ही मंगवाते हैं, अनहेल्दी खाते हैं. दे ऑर्डर फूड ऑनलाइन और दे ऑर्डर फूड फ्रॉम, दे ऑफन ईट जंक फूड. ऐसा हम मेंशन करेंगे. दैट मींस आई एम सपोर्टिंग माय पॉइंट मेंशनड इन body paragraph 1. So that's the best way of mentioning an example. So this is one of the examples. Aise aap likh sakte ho. Practically speaking, 2 examples likhne hai. Ek article ke basis pe bol do aur dusra directly you can say a research concluded that. Okay, a research in the Cape Breton University concluded that. And same thing, whatever you are giving, your ideas, you are basically example likhne ka purpose kya hai, ki aap apne ideas ko strengthen karo. For that, so aapka example relevant hona chahiye to the ideas mentioned in body paragraph 1 as well as in body paragraph 2. So that's something you really need to know. And there are various students who are not even giving one example. So kaise aayega score? It's not possible. Now we're going to talk about our second last thing, and that is, guys, punctuation. It's not only punctuation. एक last tip मैं आपको end में दूंगी, that's very important. वो आपकी final tip है जो मैं end में देने वाली हूँ, तो उस पर ध्यान देना. So guys, punctuation is using comma, full stop, semicolon and hyphen. Make it a point कि आप comma, full stop, semicolon, hyphen जरूर करो. Guys, basically क्या है, whatever points I'm explaining, I'm going to post the videos related to every other topic or every other strategy. I'm going to mention in this video. So I'll be posting videos related to that particular strategy. So do give me a thumbs up in the comment section. Zarur batao ki kis topic ke upar video chahiye. I'm going to make it for you. I'll explain that topic in detail. Okay. So punctuation ka use bahut zaruri hai. Chahiye to 7.5 or 8 band, but aapko punctuation ka use bhi nahi pata. So make it a point ki punctuation pe focus karo. Jahan pe semicolon, main aapko ek example deti hu. Semicolon kahan use kar sakte ho? You can easily use semicolon before therefore and however. So you can use these two words in introduction itself, and however आप easily introduction में use कर सकते हो, therefore conclusion में कर सकते हो. So if you are using however in the center of the sentence, in the middle of the sentence, then you can put semicolon before this and comma before however or therefore. So take care of punctuation marks. Okay, definitely इससे score improve होना ही होना है. Okay, now the last thing guys, okay, that I'm going to explain. ठीक है, so seventh thing, ठीक है, that is grammatical range of sentences. आप use कर रहे हो only one particular type of sentence, so you have to use variety of sentences. Okay, variety कैसे use करोगे? Complex sentences use करो. I have a very wonderful tip for complex sentences, guys. इसके लिए I'm going to post another video as well. Bands brew. Variety of connectors use करो. सोचना ही नहीं पड़ेगा कौन कौन से करने हैं. जब भी ऐसे लिखना शुरू करते हो, planning sheet पे bands brew लिख दो. पर आपको याद आ जाएगा कि ये वाला connector missing है और आप वो same connector use कर लोगे. So that is for complex sentences. B stands for because of, A stands for although, okay, N stands for not only but also, D for despite, S for since, then B for besides this, R for rather than, E for either or W for while or whereas. Along with this, आप however use कर सकते हो, क्योंकि this is the particular connector which can be used in every other essay, okay, so you are going to use this. कंपाउंड सेंटेंसेस भी होने चाहिए, कॉम्प्लेक्स सबसे ज्यादा होने चाहिए. टोटल ऑफ 13 to 14 सेंटेंसेस में आपका पूरा एसे ओवर हो जाएगा. सो कॉम्प्लेक्स सेंटेंसेस आपके होने चाहिए समवेयर अराउंड 9 to 10, कंपाउंड सेंटेंसेस 1 to 2, ओके, एंड देन वन पैसिव सेंटेंस जो इंट्रोडक्शन में इजिली मैंशन कर सकते हो. इट हैज बीन आर्ग्यूड, ओके, और इट इज बिलीव बाय सम. इट हैज बीन आर्ग्यूड, इट इज बिलीव बाय सम. And the last is interrogative sentence. Guys, very important one. Conditionals bhi use karoge. Next is conditionals. ठीक है, so you can use two conditionals. थोड़ा बहुत आप change कर लोगे. जैसे total of 9 complex sentences, 1 compound sentence, 1 passive sentence. ठीक है, 2 conditional sentences and 1 interrogative. Interrogative एक से ज्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए. And that you can easily use in body paragraph 2. Is there any other reason? Is there any other reason causing obesity? Is there any other reason leading to obese people? Is there any other cause of obesity in our country? So, आप लिखोगे question mark? Certainly there is. Certainly there is. ओके और आप एक्सप्लेन करोगे आगे क्या पॉइंट है आपका. सो दैट समथिंग यू आर गोइंग टू डू. सो बेसिकली गाइस दीज आर दी सेवन स्ट्रेटजीज विच आर यू विच डेफिनेटली विल बेनिफिट यू एंड योर स्कोर्स विल रिमार्केबल इंप्रूव. ड्रास्टिक चेंज यू आर गोइंग टू सी, दैट्स माय श्योरिटी. पर ध्यान से वीडियो देखो, दो बार देखो, अपने नोट्स प्रिपेयर करो एंड देन यू स्टार्ट डूइंग दिस. आपको किसी भी टॉपिक में प्रॉब्लम आ रही है आस्क मी. बैंड्स ब्रू के ऊपर आई हैव ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड वन वीडियो वेयर इन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन कि बैंड्स ब्रू एग्जैक्टली क्या है, डिटेल में एक्सप्लेन करा हुआ है मैंने. ओके सो दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू. ठीक है. सो बेसिकली बैंड्स ब्रू वाली स्ट्रेटेजी वहां से आपको मिल जाएगी गाइज. जैसा कि मैंने बोला था, आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू वन फाइनल टिप एट द एंड एंड दैट इज समथिंग विच विल हेल्प यू इन गेटिंग 0.5 band extra and that's basically proofreading guys. Proofreading, ठीक है, very important guys. ठीक है, that's the only reason I'm highlighting it with red color. आपको proofreading पे 5 minutes end में devote करने चाहिए. Planning में 7 minutes करें. Okay, planning and reading the question में 7 minutes. Then 25 minutes, 25 to 28 minutes for writing the answer and last 5 minutes for proofreading. Proofreading होते क्या है? आप actually you are going to leave one line after every paragraph. But proofreading में आपने sentence नहीं पूरा change करना. You just have to look for tenses कि आपने tense correct use करा है. Then कि कोई preposition तो गलत use नहीं करी है. ठीक है. And the last thing is जो आपने इजी वर्ड्स यूज करे हैं उन्हें आप डिफिकल्ट से रिप्लेस करो. इजी वर्ड्स टू डिफिकल्ट वंस. बस यही काम करना है प्रूफ रीडिंग में. आप यहाँ पे आइडियाज नहीं चेक कर सकते. लेट्स से आपको कोई आइडिया इररिलेवेंट लग रहा है, वो प्लानिंग वाला काम था. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डू इट हेयर यू आर वेस्टिंग अ लॉट ऑफ योर टाइम. सो डोंट डू इट हेयर. प्रूफ रीडिंग इज ओनली कन्फाइंड टू चेकिंग योर टेंसेस, चेकिंग द ग्रामर इन योर एसे and changing the easy words, okay, to difficult ones. That's all for the session, guys. And I'll recommend you, ye kabhi bhi miss mat karna, okay? So, apni speed is tarike se develop karo that you can write your answer in 35 minutes. You can plan, understand and write the answer in 25 minutes so that you have 5 minutes left for proofreading. So, guys, I hope this video is definitely going to benefit. I'm sure. I cannot say I am hoping today. I'm 100% sure. Agar main itni confident hu, to aap bhi bahut dhyan se dekho and definitely aapko isse benefit hoga. 20 essays likho. Or you can definitely take assessments from me. Writing task ke assessment aap apni mere se le sakte ho. Aapko pata chalega ki aap kya mistakes kar rahe ho. And main sample answer ke upar bhi video upload karungi. Bands brew ke upar already uploaded hai. So jahan pe complex sentences nahi samajh aa rahe, go through Bands brew. Thanks a lot for watching this session. And I hope you are going to get a lot from it. Thank you guys. Thanks a lot.